Especiales elegidos.
Bien, eso significa que el altavoz implantado funciona correctamente.
Comenzamos.
Canales de Telehit, ¿cómo están? Nos encontramos en un especial de lujo aquí en Los Ángeles, California. Una chica impresionante que ha hecho muy bien su labor con todo su material discográfico. Tiene preparado nuevo material discográfico. Se llama I'm Not Dead, sale por ahí del 3 de abril. Y estoy hablando de Alicia Moore, mejor conocida como Pink. Thank you very much for coming to this interview. How are you doing?
Good.
Cool. So, first question, I'm Not Dead. What do you want to express with this album?
A lot of different things. When I first started the record, I didn't think I had anything to say. I always go through that. I suck. I have nothing to contribute. What if I can't sing? And then I wrote 40 songs. And then they tried to make me wrap it up. I was like, wait, two more subjects. So, yeah, I was very inspired by the world around me, obviously. I have a lot to say. I always have a lot to say. But a lot of different subjects that I've never sort of broached before.
Now, a stupid girl, do you think that it's time to make like a wake-up call to the new generation of girls?
Absolutely.
Why?
I think it's past due. Because I was talking to this old hippie. And he said, I remember in my day, kids your age were barefoot, running around, drawing their names on their foreheads, trying to change the world. Now all you care about is what handbag you have, what shoes you're wearing, and how skinny you are. He said, it's pathetic. I said, well, don't lump me in that category. I agree with you. But yeah, no one my age is trying to change the world. And this is a time, again, where people should be thinking and active, and you know, maybe that's just some of us, but I think there's a very one-sided image being forced down people's throats.
Yeah.
And it's not healthy, and I think it's ridiculous.
I'm talking about the video. Honestly, who came with the idea of doing this kind of parody of some pop artist? You or David Myers, the director?
It's always both of us. Originally, it was me. I had a very set idea of what I wanted to do, and he embellished upon it, and we went there. And him and I are a great team because we have the same sense of humor. It works. We're not afraid to have fun.
I was listening to the album, and the bonus track, I Have Seen the Rain. I really like the story behind the song, that your father wrote it.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell us like a little bit the story about the song?
He wrote the song in Vietnam, and which was 40 years ago. Yeah. I can't believe it was that long ago. And it was the first song I ever learned, the first time I learned to harmonize. Me and my dad sang it growing up. For me, at all Vietnam vet functions, and you know, it was my first glimpse of what singing in front of an audience was like. And I just love him. I love his voice. He plays the out of a guitar, and I always wanted to record the song with him. It was his first time in a studio, and he was adorable and nervous and humble and cute, and it was awesome. It was amazing to do.
And what did he tell you when you just tell him, hey, I'm gonna do this song in the new album?
He thinks I'm insane. Everything I do, he thinks I'm insane, but this one was kind of a cake topper. I wanted to record it, and he was like, oh, that'll be fun. You know, we'll just record it, and we can listen to it ourselves. And I'm like, no, I'm putting it on the record. He's like, oh, you're crazy. And then I sent him the paperwork. I'm like, sign this. He's like, what's this for? I'm like, I'm putting it on the record. He's like, you're crazy. Why would you want to ruin your record? I'm like, I'm not. It's beautiful. So he's happy.
Talking about that time when you were little, You start working with, for a little time, with these bands called Basic Instincts and Choice, right?
Mm, yeah.
What could be like the biggest lesson of that time?
I'm a chameleon. I think it's important to, I mean, I trained classically. I sang gospel in all black churches and I had a punk band. I think it's important to try everything. And I play drums, but my voice is my instrument. So it's important to use it in every way that you can to get better, you know? Don't be narrow-minded, and that's what being indifferent. I mean, Basic Instinct, I was the token white girl, and Choice was this white R&B group, and, you know, it's just a lot of different things. It was really good for my resume.
Cool, one really important thing that happened in your life is that you get married. We don't want to talk about that because I know it's private, but a lot of people from Costa Rica are watching the channel right now, and they ask me, why did she choose Costa Rica to get married?
Love Costa Rica.
Why?
I love the people there. I just love the country. I love everything about it. Carrie's been there several times on surf trips, and he took me there to Manuel Antonio. And Tamarindo, and I just love it. I love it. I saw a three-toed sloth.
and it changed like the your way of life, being married or not being married, or is basically the same,
No, I've seen Carrie probably twice, total of 4 hours since the honeymoon.
So it's hard.
It's been like that our entire relationship. We're good like that. He's my buddy. He's my man. You know, he's everything. He's cool. I see him when I can. He sees me when we can, and we do our thing. It's good.
Talking about Mexico, you went to Mexico a couple of years ago with Lenny Kravitz, mm-hmm. Actually the biggest scenario in Mexico, the Estadio Azteca.
Yeah.
What is like the best memory that you have in Mexico?
My best memory from that show is doing body shots in the dressing room right before we went on stage, and my drummer broke his pinky. His from this knuckle went out like this. It was gnarly. It was awesome. At the end of the show, he's like, I think I broke my finger. I'm like, oh yeah, maybe. It looks kind of funny. That was a good show. That was a good time.
You also are gonna do a lot of things besides music. You're gonna be in movies, in a new movie called Catacomb, right? What is your character about?
I play Shannon Sassman's older sister.
Okay.
And I'm sort of this expatriate that runs off to Paris and starts to study at the Sorbonne, and you know, I'm just very anti, and I am dating one of these guys, based on a true story. They have these illegal parties in the catacombs under Paris. And there's like 3 million dead bodies under there. And the cops have never been able to catch these people. So the movie is based on this true story, and something goes very wrong. And it's sort of psychological because it also portrays how cruel siblings can be to each other. And I'm sort of the cruel one, which was a stretch for me.
It's cool to be the cruel one in a movie.
It is.
You can do whatever you want.
Yeah.
And talking about a lot of rumors about that you're gonna do the movie of Janis Joplin live. Is that right?
It's possible. It's the sort of thing where it has to be right. And I've let it go back into the universe, and if it comes back, it's meant to be. And if not, cool.